It's going to be a fun day tomorrow. I'm really looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to facing the challenge of marrying again. It's a wonderful test. I think that there are holes that are obviously very difficult par, some of the hardest par holes that we've ever played, but we've also have a number of birdie opportunities, much more so than in years past. And so there's a great mixture of holes, and it's been fun to test ourselves.
Talk about the birdie on 17.
Well, on the tee, I'm just thinking three. I mean, I just want to hit the green and make par and see if I can make a putt. But the four iron I hit was the, you know, I just stood there and admired it. It was one of the best shots I've ever hit. I mean, it just was right down the center of the green, and I was hoping it would kind of get the right bounces and so forth, and it did. It left me a beautiful uphill putt that I could be aggressive with, and I made it. And that was fun to do that, because that's just not a hole you expect to get one back.
Bill, how many times have you led the U.S. Open after 54 holes, and does this time feel a little bit different with all the experiences that you've had?
I love being in the thick of it. I've had opportunities in years past, and it has been so fun, even though it's been heartbreaking to come so close a number of times and let it slide. But I feel better equipped than I have ever felt heading into the final round of U.S. Open. My ball striking's better than it's ever been. My putting's been better than it has been in years, and I feel very, very comfortable on this golf course. I love it. And given that I've had some past major championships now and some successes, I feel as well-equipped as I could be heading into tomorrow's final round. I think it's going to be fun. I have the opportunity to play with a friend of mine, Hunter Mahan, and his caddy Woody's a great guy, good friends of Bones and I, and it should be a fun day.
You said last night that you thought the greens today would be more receptive after a bunch of lip-outs today. Do you still feel that way?
They were much smoother today than they were yesterday by far. You know, the 4 or 5 footers, you didn't sweat over as much, because if you started online, they would go in. So it made a big difference.
I feel like, you know, yesterday and today, if you would have made half those birdie attempts that you've had, you could have a 4 or 5 shot lead.
That's true. Yeah, that's true. I've come very close. Today I hit a number of good putts that didn't quite go in and had opportunities. I mean, the putt on the last hole, you know, I didn't want to hit it too hard because I thought it'd go through the break. I tried to get the right pace and it pulled up short right in the center. And things like that the one on 16, I couldn't hit a better putt. I was waiting for it to just eke a little bit left at the hole, and it never did. And those opportunities will hopefully fall in tomorrow, because I'm getting the ball started on my line with the right pace. And I can't worry about what could be. I've got to go out tomorrow and play a good round.
So as a five-time runner-up, do you feel more pressure tomorrow?
I don't think I feel any more pressure than anybody else who, you know, wants to win the tournament, major championship, the U.S. Open. But it would certainly mean a lot to me that this is a tournament for years I've had opportunities I've come close to, and it would mean a lot tomorrow if I could play some of my best golf, certainly if I can play the way I have been.
What's it going to take to win the U.S. Open?
A low score, you know, good score tomorrow. I don't know what number that is, but I do believe I've got an under par round of me tomorrow, even with the difficult pins and possibly firmer conditions.
So your birthday, Father's Day, U.S. Open Championship, pretty good trifecta.
It's got the makings to be something special, but I still have to go out and perform and play some of my best golf.